How are you enjoying the London Film Festival?
I'm loving it. It's great to be here. And well, the first screening I saw was The Reluctant Fundamentalist, which I was here for. And it was the first time, it's my first movie. I got to see it for the first time. So it was a big night for me. And exciting times, yeah.
For your first movie, you're working with an incredible cast. What was it like working with those guys?
Unreal. It was amazing. I didn't know it was, I mean, it didn't sink in till even now when I actually sat and saw it. I mean, it's been a year since we shot the movie, but just 2 days ago when I sat and saw it was when it really sunk in. Okay, so it's like, it's all there, you know, they're there, I'm there, the movie's just, it's an amazing movie. It's not just because of the cast, but because of the content. It's an intelligent movie, and I'm so glad to count it as one of my credits and as the first movie I've ever done, because it's just an amazing experience and an amazing opportunity that came my way. It's, even with Mira, working with somebody like her for the first time is unbelievable. Yeah.
For those who are looking forward to seeing the film, can you tell us a little bit about The Reluctant Fundamentalist, also about your character?
My characters are very... In the movie, actually, I had absolutely no problems relating to Bina, which is my character's name, which is the main protagonist's sister. She was very close to her life and her character, even her mood, her personality, very close to me. So as far as the performance goes, I think it came very easy, it came very naturally. But I loved that within my screen time, I got to play around with a lot of different moods, and it was very snappy. It was very quick, but there was a lot of dimensions and a lot of little nuances as far as moods are concerned. And that's how the movie is, anyway. It's for anybody who's looking forward to catching it in the near future. It's definitely very thought provoking. It's got a lot of food for thought. It's sort of trying to push us to question some very sensitive issues and shed some refreshing new light on them, which is great to see. And I think it's handled beautifully, very sensitively.
You talk about how it's handled. Of course, Mira was the director. What's so special about her as a director?
She is, she was the first movie director I'd worked with. So the first movie director I worked with is a woman. But shortly after that, I signed up a few other movies, and I've been working with male directors. But I must say, in retrospect now, that working with her was just, and it's not just because she's a woman director. It's because of who she is. She's just so warm and compassionate, and her vision and her intelligence and knowledge are just so, they're so vast. And you'll never just hear her sitting and talking about it, but you can pick up on it, and working with her, you just realize how good she is at what she does, and how amazing it is to see her handling her actors as well. She doesn't really, I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know how much direction I'd get. I didn't know how much, but she left it completely up to me, and I think most of the actors flourished under that. Yeah.
It's an adaptation of an incredibly popular book. What will people who maybe have read the book and are apprehensive about seeing the film take away from it?
I think people who have read the book are going to enjoy the movie even more. I do feel like what there was in the book has been largely developed and taken forward into a very specific direction for the movie. I mean, Mira's taken cinematic license, and when she converted it for the screen and worked on the screenplay, Mohsin Hamid was part of the adaptation, which I think is amazing for him to adapt it for the screen and know where he's coming from, know what he wants to turn it into. His involvement, I think, was key, and somewhere between his vision and what he was trying to say when he wrote the book and turning into a thriller. The movie's definitely a lot more thrilling than the book, And the pace has sort of been, it's snappy, it's quick, it's fast-paced. So that kind of cinematic license, I think for cinema goers, having an intellectual conversation, watching an intellectual conversation, and then also having it entertain you is the perfect balance.
Now, you said, obviously, you've been working with Mira, but you're working with some male directors now. Can you tell us about the projects that you're on?
I'm doing one. I live in Lahore, and which was amazing because the movie is set in Lahore, and it was just so unreal to sit and watch my city and the authenticity with which it was treated and exposed. But other than that, yeah, one movie that I'm doing back in Lahore is an all-out commercial action movie by an up-and-coming director. His name is Bilal Ashari. Very young. He's a filmmaker from San Francisco School of Filmmaking. And then there's another one that I'm doing here, actually, in London with Jamil Delvi, who is, he lives here. And we know him very, very dearly back home as the guy who made Jinnah. Yeah, and then there's another it's all over the place. It's a global affair. I've been traveling a lot. I've been working very hard, but I've been having a lot of fun. The last but not the least is an Indian movie, but it's not your typical Bollywood masala movie. It's very different. It's a biopic on Milkha Singh, who was an Olympic runner in the 1950s. It's a period movie directed by Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra. So yeah, that's it.
Wow, lots going on. Thank you very much. We'd love to meet you. Thank you.